Wilson, as Steve just noted, you were just named head coach at St. Joe's Prep, and that is one of the most competitive and prestigious high schools in the region. In fact, the last two Philadelphia mayors are St. Joe's Prep alums. The football teacher has ranked, I know for sure, top 10 nationally. I want to say top 5 nationally, maybe the last 3 or 4 years running. The basketball program, however, hasn't really been able to keep up with the Newman Garettis, Archbishop Woods, Roman Catholic, Archbishop Ryan, and McDevitt in recent years. So I want to ask you, I know you wanted to get back in the saddle, you wanted to sit in the big chair again, but why St. Joe's Prep? And why would you choose to follow the winningest coach in high school basketball history in Philadelphia, man? It's a tall task you're facing here.
Too loud to turn away. People crying out for answers, but I found myself with nothing to say. So I pondered on my purpose, the reason for who I be. So I'd have something to pass on, some positive energy, baby. Because the
power is, I guess I'll start soon. Following Speedy. Obviously, Speedy's a legend, you know. It's not going to be – I'm not really going to be able to, like, fill his shoes, but more so, like, follow in his footsteps and learn from the things that he's done. All the players that I've ever spoken to that Speedy coached, they talk about the relationships and, you know, how he cared about his players. So I think it's beyond just the basketball. I know he has over 1,000 wins, but those relationships that he's built, you know, those are things that I strive – that's the reason that I got into coaching. So making sure we keep those that first and foremost, like why we got here, right? Not just about wins and losses. Now, as far as St. Joe's Prep, for me, I think that a lot of times young people have to make a choice where, you know, either they're going to go the academic route or they're going to go the athletic route. And you see when they choose a school, sometimes they'll go to a certain, you know, school, maybe a Friends League school or certain schools when they're targeting academics. For me, St. Joe's Prep just seems like it's a one-stop shop where you can have elite academics and elite athletics all in one place, and it's right in the middle of the city. Obviously, the institution has, you know, long tradition, high academics, as far as basketball. I mean, as far as sports in general, you know, like you mentioned, their football team, national level. It takes a lot for any program to get to a national level, and I think the institution is a big part of that. So me knowing where I want to go with the basketball program, and like Steve mentioned, you know, it's beyond just wins and losses. You know, we teach life lessons through basketball. But as far as the basketball aspect, we want to be a national level team. We want to be one of the best teams on the East Coast and in the region. So St. Joe's Prep provides everything that you would need there. And like I said, the institution knows how to nurture that type of program. So it's definitely going to be hard to follow Speedy. I reached out to Speedy. That was my first phone call I made. I got a chance to talk to him. He's breaking down, you know, the players and telling me, you know, I mean, he's still really sharp. I talked to Keith Morris as well. So I'm going to use Speedy as a mentor. And hopefully, you know, I could get half the amount of wins he got. But my work is cut out for me for sure.
Well, you're a Hall of Famer if you get 500 wins, man.
Right.
Steve, let's help him out here. We've watched, you and I have watched Wood, McDevitt, Archbishop Ryan, and even O'Hara last year become really, really competitive in that Catholic League. Now, you've been a key, advisor, mentor to several D1 players in the region. You know, you got Junior Fortnot, played at Roman, played collegiately at Ryder, Seth Lundy, another great high school player at Roman, and a very, very good Big Ten player as a freshman. We're looking for big things from him at Penn State. You got Aaron Estrada, who did some time at Woodbury, finished at St. Benedict's, played at St. Peter's, and now he's going to Oregon. So you're very, very familiar with elite high-level players, and those are just a few. What advice do you have for Jason as he tries to make St. Joe's Prep more attractive to this caliber of player that is, you know, trying to figure it out in the greater Philadelphia, South Jersey region? How can he best sell the program that he's trying to build or reestablish over at St. Joe's Prep?
Well, the one thing that I would start, I'm going to start with two different areas. I'm going to start with South Jersey first. One of the things that I have always admired about St. Joe's Prep is that, you know, they actually have transportation from South Jersey to St. Joe's Prep. You know, I had tried to get Roman Catholic to do it in some of these, you know, some of these other schools, but St. Joe's Prep has done it, and they've done a really, really good job. I think that there's a lot of talent, Jason, over in that South Jersey area that tends to get overlooked. A lot of it is because, you know, Philadelphia is the fifth largest city in the country. So I think people focus primarily on what's coming out of here. But when you look at, like you said, I mean, if you just look at the Philadelphia Catholic League, you know, and Dale, you correct me if I'm something wrong with some of these players. Jordan Hall is a Jersey kid.
Yeah, down by the shore.
The other kid that's going to Bowling Green is a South Jersey kid. 6'7". He's from New McGrady, 6'7" kid.
What's his name, Jason? The athletic kid.
Cam.
Yep.
Who? Oh, Cam. Yes, Cam. Seth Lundy, you know, Aaron Estrada. Newman had a couple of kids, from Team Final that went down there. So
Astoria was a South Jersey kid.
Astoria was a South Jersey kid. Kyle Thompson's a South Jersey kid. There's a lot of good talent over there. And I think that, you know, one of the things that I would strongly encourage you is to get over there and really recruit. You know, there's a lot of good talent over there. They're very, very good communities. Voorhees, there's actually an eighth grade kid, Moses Hips from over in Voorhees.
Yeah, I know him real well. I know Jay Hips.
Hips. Okay, yeah. Jay Hips and I are very, very good friends. I think Moses is going to be a really, really good freshman. The thing, Jason, that you have the advantage, there's a lot of people of color that live over in these South Jersey communities. And trust for us is a big, big thing. You know, we want somebody that not only is able to relate to what we're going through, to our struggles, to the plights, because there are going to be kids that are going to come through St. Joe's Prep that are going to have to find their way. And they're going to have to be able to navigate through certain environments and through certain realities.
Socially, culturally, academically,
exactly,
geographically, everything over there.
And they're going to want somebody that is going to be able, that they can understand and they can turn to. And the thing that the best advice I would give you, brother, is allow those kids to trust you and get their trust, because you have to do your job as a basketball coach. But I think these kids now in today's world are looking for more than just a coach. They're looking for a mentor. They're looking for somebody that they can talk to about their mental health issues and all those things that come with being an athlete. You know, Dell and I have this conversation all the time about social media and how much of a mental disruption that can be to these kids as they're trying to, you know, live these lives through social media that we didn't have to go through. I think that St. Joe's Prep is going to speak for itself academically, but I think that your ability to get out there and recruit and go and talk, and I think to be able to relate to these parents is really, really going to help. And tear down the gap that people have attended of what people's perceptions historically have been of St. Joe's Prep. I'm always been a big advocate of just being very, very transparent. Whatever the feelings were historically about, I know how I felt about the prep when I was in high school and we thought it was the uppity school and things of that kind of nature. I think you get a chance. I think this is a telling sign that St. Joe's Prep is really looking forward, really looking to make a transition into the 2020s by bringing on an African-American coach and allowing him to be able to input his ideologies and his beliefs as a basketball head coach into these kids.
I think you mentioned earlier when you mentioned like the school behind the gate, right? When I talked to St. Joe's Prep in the committee, my thing was we don't want to build a bigger gate. We want to build a bigger table. So let more people come eat at that table. I want to use that You know, it's right in the heart of North Philly. I've coached a bunch of kids from North Philly who said they've never been in St. Joe's Prep Gym ever growing up, you know. So we want to use that resource. And I know every kid from North Philly can't go to St. Joe's Prep. It's probably not the best fit for them. But when we talk about camps and just making that accessible to the community, you know, and doing it the right way, we definitely want to change that perception immediately.
I gotta know.
My heart is pounding faster, yeah. As I'm filled with urgency. This life that I'm trapped in, deep down inside, is hurting me. But now my baby's getting older, and I owe it to his smile.